We'll have term limits for Congress. And mandatory mental competency tests for politicians over 75 years old.
So everybody is saying that that is a shot at Trump. Did you catch the shot? Maybe some of you did. It's like looking at one of those magic eye puzzles back in the late 90s. So blah, blah, term limits. They're not actually going to do that. And then mental competency tests. Well, but no, wait. If you actually put her on the spot, she'd say, I'm talking about Joe Biden.
That's or all about Feinstein. Him, you
know, or Feinstein. It's a sleepy Joe, you know, I'm criticizing. Yeah, but he's 80. Why'd you put the threshold 75? Is it because Trump is 76? So it's a way of, this is the biggest attack against her that everyone seems to have identified, against him from her, that everyone has identified. And you kind of have to meter halfway on it as an attack. It might be criticizing Trump, but she won't specifically say anything. If you pressed her with a follow-up question, she would say that he's totally sane and all that nonsense. So this is not it. This is not gonna get you past Trump. Were you guys in a coma in 2016? He would be on a stage with 15 people and every one of them was like, I'm gonna take the high road. He's kicking me in the nuts. So I don't know how she thinks this is gonna win it for her. But anyway, Anna, that's what we've
I will say one thing, and it's the tiny, tiny silver lining that came along with the Trump era. Because prior to the Trump era, you gotta remember, the Republican Party had been incredibly successful in branding themselves as the strong ones. We're gonna protect the country, national security, right? They always presented themselves as these tough guys and tough women. Well, then you have this incredibly pathetic man come along and just cut them down and reveal to the American public just how pathetic and weak they really are. And I have enjoyed that, I will say.
I've enjoyed that too. Anyway, yeah, this is pathetic. You know, I forget who posted on Twitter, but somebody posted this. I thought it was a great point. And they said, this is the series of two questions that should be the beginning of the first Republican debate. When Trump is on stage and DeSantis and Nikki Haley and all of them, Pompeo, whatever. First question should be, who won the 2020 election? Because almost all of them are gonna have to say that Trump won. Because they know that even more popular than Trump is the idea that the election was stolen. They can't deny that the election was stolen because then the base will reject them. So the follow-up question should then be, so then why are you running against Donald Trump? The election was stolen from him, shouldn't he have a chance to? Like, it's so stupid, the whole thing, it's so inconsistent. I've been trying to understand what the point of all this is. So I'm gonna lay out my theory really briefly. Consider this a prediction, maybe. Other than just she's doing this to launch a podcast in 6 months or to sell a book or cameos. I don't know. That's always possible. People run for the presidency for that. Here's the other way. She is going to get 2 to 5% of the vote in these things. That's basically it. For her to win the nomination, that's nothing. For DeSantis to win the nomination, that could be pretty significant. He could use those 2 to 5 points. So if she talked to Trump on the phone about her running for president, maybe it was, I'm gonna run and I'm not gonna criticize you. I'm gonna imply that criticizing you would be bad, in fact. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna present a respectable alternative that'll soak up a little bit of the vote and split that vote that could be going to Mike Pompeo, you know, Pence or DeSantis. And then after she helps to take out DeSantis, then she gets to be VP. That's a plausible reason to do this. More plausible is that that is the deal that they struck, but in the end he chooses Carrie Lake over anyway, which would be hilarious. But anyway, this is pure speculation, Anna, but what do you think?
I think John B. hypothesizing. That's what I think. I like that. I like this that hypothesis.
Speculation.
Right? Because I mean, to me, look, I can't put myself in her shoes. All I could think about is what I would do in her position as someone who would genuinely want to run for president. Mm-hmm. I would go in and I'd punch him in the mouth, politically, of course, right?
Yeah.
The fact that she's not doing that, to me, signals that she's not serious about running for president. And you know what? Maybe she's not serious about running for president. So I do like your hypothesis. I'm curious to see how it all plays out. But I will say this, the idea that there was a small period in time during the news cycle where there were rumors about Marjorie Greene potentially running as Trump's VP. And I just, it's still possible. Let's try to prevent that in any way we can, right? So if Nikki Haley's conspiring with Trump, cool. Look, I'd rather
I'll
have
still
that.
I'll pick her over Kari Lake and Marjorie Greene, I guess.